Welcome to the dedication ceremony for the United States Army Officer Candidate School Arches. Please rise for the playing of the national anthem and the invocation.
Mysteries, we ask for your presence among us. We ask you bless this day and each event as it unfolds. We ask that you bless our efforts today, that we will create a legacy that will impact many generations to live lives of service, character, and leadership. We ask all this in your name. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming the Commandant of the United States Army Officer Candidate School, Lieutenant Colonel Matthew P. Neumeyer.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for attending today. I'd like a moment to recognize our distinguished guests and friends of OCS who've attended today. Major General retired Charles Gales, Brigadier General Bob Walters, also in attendance, up here with us, Vice Admiral retired Byrd from USAA, and also Bradley Williams from Rivertown Buick GMC, our very gracious sponsors, along with the OCS Alumni Association. I also would like to take a note to thank the over 15 colonels, both active and retired, 15 lieutenant colonels, active and retired, and our many, many guests from across Fort Benning. A very notable assemblage of rank and experience here underneath our two tents. Without your gracious support and your sacrifice as graduates of OCS, we wouldn't be here today. I have the honor of introducing our guest speakers. Our first guest speaker is my boss, Colonel David Beachman, who commands the 199th Infantry Brigade Leader Development. I think it is appropriate, and we're very thankful that he made time today to talk to us about at our dedication for the Arches, because the Leader Brigade, a new entity and a special entity here on Fort Benning, really symbolizes what we can achieve and what OCS was designed to achieve. So without further ado, Colonel David Beachman.
Well, good morning. Friends, family, distinguished guests, community leaders, fellow soldiers and civilians of the Maneuver Center of Excellence. On behalf of Major General Miller and Command Sergeant Major Gooden, and all the leaders across the Fort Benning and the local community, thank you for attending today's OCS Arches dedication ceremony. I would like to especially acknowledge the OCS Alumni Association, all those OCS alumni that are in attendance today, those current OCS Hall of Famers, and as well as the many corporate sponsors in attendance today. Your continued support is greatly appreciated, and it is critical to the success of this premier commissioning program. Finally, I'd like to recognize those alumni selected for this year for induction into the OCS Hall of Fame that are here with us today. First of all, congratulations and welcome back to your alma mater. Ladies and gentlemen, I am honored to share in this ceremony with you, especially here in the Taylor Field Cortel, the site of the new and old Officer Cannon School campus. What's not mentioned in your programs is that this Cortel was the original location for the school during World War II. So in a sense, the school has finally come home to its roots. However, the consolidation of OCS onto its new campus is not complete without its arches, a true symbol of OCS, a symbol that has stood for 50 years at Fort Benning, and from its inception, marked the beginning of OCS as a permanent commissioning source in the U.S. Army with strategic importance. The arches represent a military tradition, symbolizing the threshold upon which candidates cross and embark on a journey of personal discovery and learning, where they'll be weighed and measured and tested in a hope of being found worthy of becoming an officer, a servant leader to our nation's most precious natural resource, our sons and daughters. The arches signify the unique character of OCS, that when the nation calls, citizens will raise their hands, volunteer to serve, and lead with desire, dedication, discipline, and duty. With today's ceremony, we complete the consolidation of OCS with the reestablishment and the rededication of its arches at the campus's entry and exit points, bringing to culmination the consolidation of 73 years worth of symbols, artifacts, and traditions within the new OCS campus footprint. It is here on these hallowed grounds where the past is once again reunited with the present. However, this arch dedication would not have been possible without the continued support of our OCS Alumni Association and in partnership with the United States Automobile Association and the Rivertown Auto Mall. You have our deepest appreciation and gratitude for the support you have given us over the years and continue to give. This ceremony also provides us with an opportunity to reaffirm our commitment to ensuring our OCS program remains relevant and able to produce the leaders our nation requires to meet the challenges of a future that is increasingly complex, in that it is unknown, unknowable, and constantly changing. Leaders that will not only meet these challenges, but are able to win in a complex world. We do this by driving a culture of excellence down throughout our organizations and adapting our training strategies, programs, and methodologies to ensure that we continue to train, educate, and develop physically, cognitively, and morally resilient leaders of character who are committed, competent, and imbued with an intellectual curiosity that promotes lifelong learning habits. I stand here before you confidently knowing that today's candidate, similar to those who have come before, are trained and ready to meet our nation's call and will continue to play a vital role in our nation's defense. Standards, no compromise, light, swift, and accurate, one force, one fight, this will defend.
It is my unique privilege to introduce both of the sponsors, represented first by Vice Admiral retired John Byrd, currently the Senior Vice President for Military Affairs at USAA. Though a United States Naval grad, he obviously recognizes the support that all services, and we are very, very, very honored for him and his organization, the support they've given both the Alumni Association and the OCS over the last 3 years in making sure that the arches have been able to return to the OCS home. After serving for over 30 years in the United States Navy, he's joined USAA, and we're very thankful that he could join us today. Ladies and gentlemen, Vice Admiral Byrd.
Good morning, distinguished guests, general officers, families, ladies and gentlemen, and most importantly, men and women in service and who have served our country, our veterans. Thank you very much for being here. Clearly a beautiful day. And as I look around, at this spectacular setting, this wonderful crowd, these troops in formation, one thought, one word comes to mind, and that would be "Hoo-ah!" Okay, being an old Navy sailor, I have no idea what that means, but I'm told it would be a real pleaser for this crowd. Maybe not so much. It's a distinct privilege and a great honor to be here with you today as we dedicate these new arches, signifying the unique and very special nature of Officer Cannon School and its contribution to our nation's history and overall national security. It also speaks to the Army's strong commitment to developing the future leaders who will pass through them and have passed through them, embodying service, dedication, and loyalty. I bring warm greetings from our USAA CEO, Stuart Parker, and the 27,000 employees of the USA team who come to work every day dedicated to the single purpose of serving the military community, our military, our veterans, and their families. Now, you may be wondering how a retired Navy Admiral came to this very historic, Army-centric, and completely landlocked location to participate in this dedication. The answer is simple. USAA, as a USA employee, the Army is in our blood and in our heritage. 90 years ago, USAA was founded by the Army, for the Army, at Fort Sam Houston in San Antonio, Texas. Yes, our founding fathers were 25 Army officers. They came together to ensure each other since no one else would. Now, you have to understand, 25 infantry officers, all young, driving cars, I'm not sure I'd insure them. But times have changed, and so has USAA, and we vastly expanded our services and our support to be the provider of choice for the entire military community, working to ensure their financial security. It's exciting to see this legacy project come to fruition. USAA is proud to partner with the OCS Alumni Association and Army OCS to complete this nearly two-year journey to reach this dedication milestone. It's so rewarding to see the culmination of this great effort to replant these symbolic arches here at the new OCS campus, and as the Colonel said, the historic beginning. They now stand as a significant symbol of the great legacy for all OCS candidates, past, present, and future. And what a legacy it is. There's a long line of distinguished Army leaders and OCS alumni, many sitting here, who have been transformed in this leadership training crucible. Generals, colonels, journalists, politicians, and yes, bringing it home, my little brother. Nearly 30 years ago, my little brother, now Colonel U.S. Army retired Mike Byrd, no longer my little brother, but still my younger brother, took my advice and did something meaningful with his life by joining the Army, ultimately passing through the OCS arches and proudly carrying on the strong traditions of this great institution. Now, Mike is but one of five younger brothers I'm fortunate to have. And I'll be honest with you, 30 years ago, none of us would have bet a wooden nickel on his future. But today, following a wonderful 27-year career, again, retiring as a full colonel, we could not be more proud of him or his service. And honestly, in very large part, a result of the leadership and skills he learned here. By the way, he tells me regularly he can't figure out why it took me 4 years at the Naval Academy to learn what he managed to learn in less than 4 months here. So to all of those who made this day possible, I congratulate you for ensuring this great symbol will remain for decades as an inspiration to those who follow. To our fellow sponsors, Riverton Auto Mall, our OCS Alumni Association, along with Officer Candidate Battalion Commander Lieutenant Colonel Matt Neumeier, thank you for allowing USAA to play a small part in an effort to bring these arches to the campus. Special shout out, of course, and another hoo-ah to the future Army leaders here with us today, from Honey Badger, Attack, Blackhawk, Crusher, and Danger companies, who will soon cross the threshold themselves and lead our Army. I gotta love those names, except for maybe Honey Badger. Might want to work on that. Thank you for your dedication, sacrifice, and passion in pursuing the core values. Looking at the arches today, I'm reminded of our own set of arches at USAA that employees and visitors pass through every day. Etched on a marble gateway inside our headquarters are the words, "There can be no finer calling than serving one's country." And what the OCS arch symbolizes is equally as inspiring. Be proud that through these arches pass young men and women who have answered their nation's call, who have raised their hands, volunteered to serve, and lead with desire, dedication, discipline, and duty overall. We at USA are extraordinarily proud that we could play a role in this noble effort. May God bless you, our nation, and all those that serve. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. And for our second sponsor, also a tremendous honor. Again, Fort Benning is a unique place. It's my second time I've been stationed here. I can remember first time someone told me, move to the Arches. I can also remember when they talk about the commitment that the local community has with us. So we have USAA, a sponsor, a national level, coming down to be a part of something very special, very small part, but big part in the United States Army, but also in a huge way our local community, represented here by the general manager of Rivertown Buick, Bradley Williams, a man not only a part of the an integral part of fabric of Columbus, the Phoenix City and Columbus and Fort Benning area, but as many of you know, Fort Benning is a unique place in that our borders don't stop at Columbus or Phoenix City and Fort Benning. We're all intertwined. It's a tremendous relationship. His commitment over the year and the numerous charities and organizations that him and his organization have been a part of, it is only natural that they would be here today as a part of this to represent our local community, really our good friends and brothers and sisters outside the gate of Fort Benning who are a huge part of this. Ladies and gentlemen, Bradley Williams.
Anytime somebody stands up to speak, I always ask myself two questions. One, why this guy? And two, how long is this going to take? So I promise it won't take long. And why this guy, as he said it earlier, sponsorship, right? Comes down to economics. But that was easy enough for us to participate in at the auto mall. We share a set of core values at that auto mall is professionalism, teamwork, integrity, and transparency. Every one of our 300 employees, when they're hired with us, they're given a card, and they carry that card around with them at all times. They're taped to computer screens, and it's something that we follow every day in everything that we do. Whenever we work our car deals, when we deal with our military, when we deal with the civilians, it's a set of core values, and I think we share that, and that made that a no-brainer. Like many of you here, I felt the call originally to serve my country. As a junior in high school, I enrolled in the delayed entry program for the Air Force. I spent every day after that studying, planning, dreaming about what would come of that next adventure in my life. I thought about the places I would see, what I would learn, and the friends I would make along the way. A week before basic training, I had a motorcycle accident. I broke my neck, my spine, my ribs, my knees, and if you can believe it, for some reason, I was not allowed to be in the military anymore, right? So as a civilian who has felt that need and that call to serve their country and had that ability taken away, I can't tell you how proud I am to be here today representing all 300 of those guys back home at the Rivertown Auto Mall and being a part of the legacy of the OCS and the leadership of the Army. Growing up in Columbus, I have felt that sense of pride my entire life. Every time I've driven past the gates of Fort Benning, when I see the men and women reporting for duty, I think of what that is what freedom looks like. When I look out here, I say, that is what freedom looks like. I can also tell you right now, living in Midland, I know what freedom sounds like. And when the artilleries are firing at midnight, sometimes I wish I didn't hear it at midnight, right? Make no mistake, though, that's a small price to pay when you consider the evil in this world. And then it's our great military keeping it safe. That military, like all men and women, needs leadership. It's a basic human desire, the desire and need for a leader. Hitler and Stalin understood this importance when they invaded Poland in 1939. One of the first things they did was collect all the leaders of society. They collected the educators and the educated. The leaders were sent to the Gulag. The officers of the military were sent to the Gulag or executed. And it was in that shadow of that evil that the OCS was born. In 1940, General Marshall understood the importance of having a training facility for new officers. Brigadier General Singleton, Commandant of the Infantry School, established a plan to do just that. Later in 1941, Brigadier General Courtney Hodges revised that plan and presented it to Brigadier General Omar Bradley, and the OCS school was born in July of that year. Since that time, the OCS has instilled professional ethics.
They train the fundamentals of leadership, and they've evaluated leadership potential and commissioned all those who qualify. Earlier I said it's a basic human desire, the need for leadership. Life is hard enough. It's even harder if you choose to go it alone. And sometimes you find yourself with an empty cup and you don't know which way is up, and it's the men and women of the OCS that seek out those empty cups and they fill them with what they learn here on this campus, here at Fort Benning. Whether it's taking troops into battle or standing in front of me, helping them work a car and buy their first vehicle. My pride in the Arches comes from knowing these Arches do not necessarily represent the land that they stand on. They represent the men and women who pass through them. Those men and women that keep my country safe, those men and women that allow me to go to bed as a civilian with my mind racing about how many cars I sold that day or how many people went through our service department, never thinking about all those who would take every freedom away from me if they had that chance. In some ways, they allow me to take that freedom for granted sometimes. From all those back at Rivertown Auto Mall, thank you for your service. Thank you for all you do. And thank you for allowing us to be part of your history in this historic landmark. Thank you.
And last but not least, is my honor and privilege to introduce the OCS Alumni Association representative, a unique man in this particular endeavor. As any number of years ago, he never likes to, he wants to make sure I never get his year he graduated correct. He's glad because that way he can always pass himself off as a younger man. But Colonel Ionoff was the original project officer. Ionoff's Cossacks out of OCS helped put up the first one along with the other members of the class that he was responsible for. And so he's here today to close the loop, to rededicate really for us, and that represent those original infantry OCS who placed it up, but really placed the arches for all OCS graduates. Ladies and gentlemen, Colonel John Ionoff.
What a glorious day this is for the United States Army and for the Officer Candidate School. And 50 years ago, this August, I attended a similar ceremony to the one that we're going to have today. Just a few short blocks from here, we were at next to Eubanks Field, Battalion Walkway, 5th Student Battalion, Infantry Officer Candidate School. I was a tactical officer in 54th Company OC for the class in session, which was 8-65. A project was conceived to build an archway at both ends of the battalion street. The entrance of the walkway was next to the 54th Company. The second archway was down at the other end of the battalion walkway at the 55th Company. 54th Company was then commanded by Captain Glenn Whip Wilson, and the 5th Student Battalion commander was the OCS legend and Medal of Honor winner, Colonel Nett. I was put in charge of the project, and a brief thought passed through my mind. That's all I needed to add to a tactical officer's 18-hour a day, as it was. The candidates were nearing senior status, and they took it as a challenge and completed the arches in 2 months. The original arches had a lamp on each pillar symbolizing the light of education. Each pillar also had a plate with one of the many characteristics that an officer candidate must possess. On the face of the yearbook, these same traits, duty, desire, discipline, and dedication, which have been mentioned several times, along with the archways, is on 865's class yearbook. The class distinguished honor graduate certainly possessed all those traits and many more. Colonel retired Darrell Katz is here today representing class 8-65. He will also be inducted into the OCS Hall of Fame later on this afternoon. The past 50 years have seen many OCS candidates pass through these archways and proudly carry on the traditions of excellence expected by the United States Army from all OCS graduates. The alumni here today recognize that as the pillars are a foundation supporting the steel arches, OCS is the solid foundation that provided them with the leadership skills that enabled them to be successful in their military and civilian careers. I would like to, on behalf of the OCS Alumni Association, thank USAA, Rivertown Auto Mall, IMF, Jan Heineman of JPM Marketing, Chet Freeborn, and the OCS Commandant, Lieutenant Colonel Matt Neumeyer, Captain Jefferson Davis, who has given a lot of time and effort to this, and the OCS staff for their support in getting this very important historical project completed. To the candidates present today, march proudly through these arches, remembering all those who have gone before you. Standards, no compromise. The United States Officer Candidate School Alumni Association and OCS would like to express our thanks once again by giving our contributors a gift, a rendering of the original archway by Mrs. Diane Osborne.
Candidates of Class 00515 will now present the OCS Alumni Association's gift to the guests in appreciation of their contribution and commitment in erecting the new OCS arches.
One more presentation that I'd like to make. Colonel Neumeyer, would you step forward, please? Colonel Matt Neumeyer has been a great inspiration to all of these candidates, but also all to the Alumni Association. He's put in time, effort, and he's so interested in the carrying on of the history and the heritage of OCS. So on behalf of the association, we're going to designate the first paver that's going on the Memorial Walk in your name. So hopefully we'll have it very soon, and we'll be able to place it properly. And also another little token, an official OCS alumni coin. Thank you.
The Alumni Association always finds a way to embarrass me in some shape, form, or fashion. I'll just add the last word, though, as the Commandant in the last few days. Thank you very much to the board. Thank you very much to the sponsors. Thank you very much to Chad Freeborn, who worked so hard and through the unusual Georgia monsoon to put these pillars up. Thank you, Ms. Osborne, for being here. She's going to paint us a new, brand new print of these beautiful arches, and thank you all for being here. Again, without the great contributions of these two organizations and the people out here, these candidates wouldn't have that legacy to stand on. And without it, OCS would not go on. But it does, and with that, we'll continue our ceremony.